When you hear weird stuff getting played on 92.3 WKVR, you know that J-Dox is back to make a big fuss over nothing. What's up, everybody? This is Please Cancel Me. I'm J-Dox, and this is the Saturday morning that I haven't been doing for a while. Honestly, it's been, I don't know, like a whole month or something since I got in here on a cool Saturday afternoon. Why is it so cold? Yeah, I've been busy. A lot of you guys might know because I am also cutting out a mailbag, which actually might not be dead. I might be transferring that to somebody else. Anyway, what was I talking about? I'm going to go to music again. What we just heard was To the Top by Too Many Zoos, Z-O-O-Z. And that's some cool thing I picked up from the internet just a little bit recently. It's like this trio of dudes. Like one dude on just like a single drum with like a bunch of wood blocks and cowbells and stuff. And then like I think it's two guys on alto saxophones, which are like huge saxophones. But I just found them like on the internet, just bumbling around some video of them like playing in a subway tunnel or something. And it was just really popping. So I downloaded all of their music and I paid for it too. Anyway, coming up next, what do we got? Goku v. Frieza. This is from a guy I know named Dagum. And he's a cool dude, and he does, he just makes some beats, and he does Dragon Ball over him, so, it's, you know, Dragon Ball. Get my thing going again, get that all set up, all right. You just heard was Rizzle Kicks, Down with the Trumpets, the neat remix of Rizzle Kicks. Original song Rizzle Kicks, song was Down with the Trumpets, that was the neat remix. I don't think that's cool, I've been bopping to that. And before that, we heard Goku v. Frieza by Dagum and Dalkachu. Cool dude, I know, went to school here for a bit. Now he's in Colorado doing all kinds of stuff, making beats with Dragon Ball lyrics. So, I've been out for a while. I haven't been in the studio doing radio very much because things are kicking up. I'm getting busy. The zine project, that's the word. That is coming along. We are doing that. That is still happening. And the submission thing is over, like end of March. And I like waited a whole week before I actually got started, like, you know, figuring this crap out, like doing the layout and stuff. So I've like scanned everything that I got sent in, and like I got that all compiled. I'm gonna be like reprinting it out with like the size right, and then I will like try to do the layout and the formatting sometime today, and that's gonna be fun. But God, like I got so much, and that's excellent. I got a lot of material, and it's really cool, and it's also going to be crazy, like for the final product, because I'm doing it half size, so it's like, you know, a normal like U.S. Piece of paper, 8.5 by 11, like folded in half, so things are going to be sort of like half size. And because I got a lot of writing and stuff and some really cool art, like I don't want to shrink it too much because then you'll like you'll lose it. You want it to be big enough so you can see it like right, but I do need to like, there are like somewhere I can't like have whole pages like dedicated to like an individual thing, so I'm like trying to like combine a couple pieces like to a page or something, just, you know, otherwise this is going to be like a 100 page like booklet or something. It's going to be huge. And depending on how things go today, because right after the show, I'm going to go out and I'm going to do some more of that. I might have to like do it in several iterations to do some volumes or something. And then I got to curate what goes in the first one, goes in the next one. It's a whole process now. But so that's keeping me real busy. I've been using this project to like leverage into class assignments and stuff. So while I'm doing the layout, I'm going to have one of those GoPro cameras strapped to my torso, and it's going to be recording me getting real frustrated. So coming up next on Please Cancel Me, because I'm J-Dox, and I've been listening to the Yeah Yeah Yeahs a whole lot. So here's Dull Life off of It's Blitz. It starts out quiet. All right, here we go. Come on. Don't give me this dead air, Yeah Yeah Yeahs. Oh my God, the freaking volume's down. Yep. You know, it's been like 2 years I've been doing this. I still can't. It's still like, I just... You'd think I'd know how to work it. All right. Hey, that was the Gutterati by the Fratellis off of some promo EP. I went and went back, and because I cannot stop listening to them, I got like all of their whole discography and stuff. So I've been listening to all kinds of weird stuff. Before that, it was Dull Life by the Yeah Yeah Yeahs. I'm J-Dox. It's Please Cancel Me on 92.3 WKVR. And I want to tell a real, I want to tell a story real quick. So the reason I was off last week was because early Saturday morning, I drove from like here, Central PA, all the way up to Erie to Edinburgh College, visit a friend of mine. She is a photography major at Edinburgh University. And because I was commissioning from her, I guess it was a collaborative art project. I wanted her to like to professionally do a photography shoot, a whole set of me drinking a lot of both alcohol and blue milk, and then, and this is gross, and I'm sorry, but then vomiting, because I'm going to use that for a self-portrait painting of mine. it's not something great to put out on the out on the airwaves publicly. But anyway, so we did, and that happened. She got me all set up with like these, like with this whole weird setup of like fancy curtains and like wreaths and party hats and stuff, because she has a great aesthetic. And so we just looked like some goofy people. I had like blue lipstick on, and I was just like downing tons of blue milk, which like was a really, really bad idea. Like everything went, it all went well. I got the picture I needed. She got a lot of pictures that are in her portfolio now of me being a weird, gross man. And then now I'm going to get started on my self-portrait. But that's what I was doing last weekend. And we just partied and partied and partied up there. And it was snowing. Like, it came down snowing to the point where we were in this bar. And, like, the power was out in the bar. And it was just this, like, pitch black, really crowded. They, you know, everything still worked on draft and stuff. So they were still selling beers in the pitch black. And that was a cool weekend. Anyway, so that's what I've been up to. Coming up next, Melon by the Anti-Corn League off of Womb 2. And this is something we got in the mail like a while ago, but I like it. Shouldn't say that like it's like a weird thing that I like it. What did we just listen to? That was Animal Collective, Summertime Close. And I like entry-level hipster garbage. My cue just disappeared. Before that, we listened to Watch the Tapes by LCD Sound System. And then before that, if I'm remembering correctly, it was The Melon by the Anti-Corn League. And the name is still a little bit baffling because they explicitly state they're not against corn. But so I'm really curious as to like where that name comes from. Where, like, all right, I didn't have anything set up before that. So we're going to go to Stop. This is 92.3 WKVR. I'm J-Dox, and in my side, I'm photoshopping all of the poetry we got and all that for the zine. And it's cool because I was unsure if just scanning the poems we could send in would work, but I think it is going to. I want to, like, you know, make it so it is, like, people's handwriting or typewriting specifically, because that is, like, a big part. I, like, batted around the idea of transcribing them, but that is not the case now, and I am stalling for time. Let's get sad. Let's listen to Sufjan Stevens. Vesuvius is the one I like. We're going to get sad now. Housekeeping by Chibomato off of Hotel Valentine. Before that, what we heard was Rhinestone Eyes by Gorillaz off Plastic Beach and Go Easy by Mac DeMarco. And whoops. Go Easy by Mac DeMarco. And I just lost my cue again. So which is a great segue, fantastic, to go into something else that isn't my music. We're going to Vaughn's music. I have not forgotten about you, buddy. We are, we got some Drains STH, we got Radiohead, we got Laurie Anderson, we got all kinds of things. I can't find the specific Pall Mall song called Pall Mall, like a title track, I guess, but I mean, it's just hard to look up, Pall Mall, Pall Mall. Anyway, so Vaughn, I know that this letter is coming in from like a month ago, but I do have it here, and I'm going to play your music. You were talking about the previous songs from last time, and the one of them was Tell Me What You're Here For, and that was sounded like this. Yeah, it sounded like silence is what it sounded like. Just as a little reminder, I'm not going to play this whole song, but yeah, Tell Me What You're Here For, that was the bonus track off of the Fits in the Tantrums album, More Than Just a Dream. Sorry, I totally spaced out because we had people just rolling to the station, and then it turned into a whole like weird social political discussion. And yeah, don't worry, it's not going to become the slouch. It's not gonna make it a habit of doing that. But yeah, T is always just poking her head into whatever like broadcasts I've been doing. So anyway, we're gonna go. I'm gonna play some of Vaughn's music. Blah 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 blah. No, I'm sorry, I'm not blah blahing about your letter, but I am stalling for time. Anyway, coming up right now, we've got Radiohead, the national anthem, Radiohead. All right, here we go. I'm doing, anyway. God. There we go. Are we going? Are you going? This sucks. Sorry, I'm sorry. I'm stalling so hard. All right, you keep me hanging on. Thanks for hanging on, guys. Thanks. Here's you keep me hanging on. Kim Wilde. Come on, just do it. Just do it. Just play the music. I'll refresh this thing like 9 times. There we go. Jeez. Mel Drift off of Interstate. Sorry, Vaughn, I couldn't find the Pall Mall by Pall Mall, so I just kind of chose one at random. And I like that, though. It sounded really cool. Before that, we heard Drain STH, Simon Says by Drain STH. We got From the Air by Laurie Anderson off of the album Big Science. And I really dug that, Vaughn. That was like real postmodernist. I'm all about that. We got Kim Wilde, You Keep Me Hanging On, and then, no, don't load it again, Good Times by Drinking Electricity. Shut up. Anyway, thank you for writing in again, Vaughn. I'm definitely keeping on that Laurie Anderson. That was really cool. Right, so that whole history project sounds like a colossal handful, so best of luck with that. I hate doing research, man, personally, especially like if I have to go to the library, like books or something. Nah, just see what I can get off the internet. Anyway, so something we got coming up next is going to be a couple tracks randomly off of Well, I Don't See Why Not, Volume 4, which is a cool compilation of a bunch of like small indie things that I got from the zines, actually. So I was ordering a lot of zines to do research a little while back from this website, Antiquated Press, because I wanted to read some, like, get a sense of it and all that. And they were fantastic, and I could talk about, like, the 4 I got, like, for hours. But they also sent along with the package a code to go onto Bandcamp and get this most recent volume of Well, I Don't See Why Not for free. And that was really, really chill of them. It's not Antiquated Press. It's Antiquated Future is, like, also, I think it's, like, primarily a record shop, and they also, like, sell and make zines. And they're in Portland. Yeah, who would have guessed? We're in Portland, Oregon. So we're gonna just hit some of these at random, starting with Unheld by Lil Pika. And the volume's down again.
Once is once, and never.
One was Put Me in Your Movie by Little Angry and the Sweets. Or no, it was just called Your Movie by Little Angry and the Sweets. Before that, we heard Dead Phones by Upside Drown, Paper Birds by La Dida, and Unheld by Lil Pika. And these are all at the Well, I Don't See Why Not Volume 4, a whole compilation full of good stuff that I got as an extra little gift, as a download for buying some zines, because this is my life now. Hey, you're listening to the Power 92.3 WKVR. This is J-Docs. I'm still here. I'm not canceled yet, and I'm sitting here like working on resizing some of the pictures and good stuff, all the art we got in for the zine project, which submissions are closed for that. I will like accept stuff, I guess, but it'll like open the station, but like I gotta start doing layout today, and that's why I'm resizing everything. And like I'm in a like a little bit of a pickle about some of the stuff, because I didn't want to, I guess, like do any kind of censorship or anything about it. Like I wanted to just be like the raw stuff like that people just get in. Like I don't want to like curate or like exclude anything at all, but the way this project's kind of going, like there are like a couple things that I do have to cut or alter for the final thing. Like I mean, and we like the reason behind all this, I guess, is because I'm going to be trying to sell these like at the Liberal Arts Symposium, which is like this whole like academic like convention or something that they do every year at Juniata. And Juniata might be putting it on like their like marketing stuff website. They might be like promoting the school with it about like, hey, this is what students are doing. And like there's just you know, there's like some authority oversight probably happening here. And some like alums or professors or something were like, oh, like, hey, can our daughter like send some poetry in? I'd be like, yeah, that's fine. And I didn't really broadcast that a lot of the bulk of the listener section of the submissions for this scene are coming from SCI Huntingdon. And I don't know if anyone's like going to take problem with that. But I'm putting it all in anyway. And like I got some stuff, like controversial stuff, and that's good. Like Zaki sent in like this like deposition, which is really cool. That's going in. And all kinds of other stuff. But I do have to be kind of discerning for some of this stuff. I mean, I got a drawing in that is a very graphic drawing of a woman giving birth to like a weird skeleton zombie child. And that's cool. And I love it. And I would put that in so many zines that weren't getting sent around to like professors and stuff. So I did have to cut that. I altered another one that had like F the police in it. Cause I'm like, I'm all about like the sentiment, but I don't want to get like way too political, I guess, as like, especially if like, you know, I just want to graduate. I want this to go well, and I don't want to get like in a load of shit for it. But hey, you're listening to the Power 92.3 WKVR. I'm J-Dox. I'm going to stop talking, and we're going to keep listening to more of the cool soft jams on Well, I Don't See Why Not, Volume 4, and I'm gonna figure out how anything will work. And, like, okay, so maybe it's totally unfounded. Maybe I'm just being really paranoid or something, but I am concerned that, like, people will be approaching me to it and be like, hey, there's a lot of stuff from convicts in this zine. And I'm like, there sure is. That's who listens to the freaking radio. And I just don't know if that's going to get me in some hot water with the school. But I'm going to do it anyway. But there's just like the extreme stuff I'm going to cut. Sorry. But anyway, we're going to move on now to Cold Follow Cold Comma Follow. I don't get it. By Gossamer. That was Pleasant Valleys by Arielle Burks. Before that, we heard Lion by Eleanor Murphy, preceded by I Want to See You by Christina Antipa, Synchronicity Statement Number 1 by Let's Wait, and Cold Comma Follow by Gossamer. Sorry, that was a lot of songs to take in. If you cared about them specifically, then I can get you more information on that, maybe. But anyway, those were all off of Well, I Don't See Why Not, Volume 4, coming from Antiquated Future, a cool record store in Portland that sent me zines because I bought them, but also gave me a cool code to download that, which was nice of them. So check those out. They're all on Bandcamp. There's like more volumes of that and just a whole bunch of cool people. So this has been Please Cancel Me. I'm J-Dox. Thank you, everybody, for joining me. I'm going to go work the heck on out of this zine project because I got a lot of things to organize still, but I will probably be back next week, I think. All right, see you guys.